14, 15 years, maybe longer. When he first came out from California here for career opportunities, a good friend of ours, a mutual friend of ours, asked me to talk to him and just kind of give him the lay of the land and how Washington area works, how Virginia works, and how local community here is organized. And so I did. And immediately I realized we had a number of things in common. First of all, we both lived in Vietnam. I grew up in Vietnam as a kid and was born there. Secondly, we both left the country under, as Chad referenced, not the best circumstances. In April 1975, the war ended, South Vietnam as we knew it, and democracy as we knew it, and communists took over. And so many Koreans and non-Koreans and Vietnamese who had been in that country at the time were evacuated. Many of them left as refugees and literally put their lives on the line to leave that country with no future, to live for a better future, which is right here in the United States. And so Hung and so many Asian Americans, Vietnamese Americans understand the plight. And one in particular I just want to single out is my good friend Rosemary Lauer, who's here, who wrote a book about that experience, about how she went from being literally a beggar to now a successful woman who's started a career, but because of the fact that America has given that promise of that second chance. And so for a lot of Vietnamese Americans, a lot of Asian Americans, a lot of refugees and immigrants who come here looking for that extra opportunity, Hung symbolized that. So we understood that we had that in common. A few years later when you married John, we realized we both were attracted to Korean women, and so we both had that in common. You know, it's a wonderful son, I have a beautiful son as well, and we just love being dads. But above all, just like Chad Peterson said, the thing that Hung and I and so many of us in this room, so many of us who call ourselves Democrats, the reason why we do what we do, the reason why we get out in the middle of a very hot summer day at 95 degrees and knock on doors and talk to voters, the reason why we spend all our time and effort raising money, dollar here, dollar there, to get our message out, the reason why we do this is because our government is worth fighting for. Our future is worth fighting for. Good public policy is worth fighting for. And for so long, for too long in this country, for too long in Virginia, we've had a mechanism of government that was run by people that had a different agenda, a different ideology. An ideology that said, you know what, if you've been here for four generations, okay, we're part of your system. We'll accept you. But if you haven't been here very long, we don't really care about your views, because your views should not be represented by the Commonwealth of Virginia with its long tradition. Well, folks, especially in Northern Virginia, and Chad mentioned this, diversity is not just a slogan. Diversity is reality. We have a demographic change that says that we welcome people from all around the world, and in particular, Vietnamese Americans have been here since 1975. So we're not some Johnny-come-latelys here. We are bread and butter, soul and heart of the Commonwealth of Virginia. And we are the current and the future generations of this country. We are the people that are paying taxes and becoming part of our society. And yes, we deserve a voice in the Commonwealth of Virginia as well as all around the country. So when Hung said that he wanted to consider public service, my first question to him was, do you know how hard it is? Because, I mean, we make it easy. I'm sure you made it look really easy, but it's not. It's very hard. It is very, very hard to do this job. And he said, you know, I've had some hard times. I understand hard times. I'm willing to do this. And I said, how is his wife going to take it? How is his family going to take it? And after a lot of conversations, John was willing to accept this opportunity as well. But at the end of the day, this comes down to a simple point. As Chad mentioned, elections are about what we can deliver for you as elected officials. Elections are about us representing your values, your principles, your views, making sure that every single Virginian's views are represented in the policies. That's why diversity is so important. But that's not going to happen if we don't go down to Richmond. Jerry, myself, many of us in this room are running for re-election right now and for election this year. If we are not in Richmond, your voice will not be heard. Because I can guarantee you that the gentleman that Jerry's running against, the gentleman that Hung's running against, the one that I'm running against, the people that are running against us or us running against them, they have a different agenda. Their agenda says taxes ought to be so low that only the wealthiest people can benefit, because the money that comes in from the taxes will not be able to fund the core functions of education, transportation, all the things we care about. They have this attitude that says the government should be a platform for a social religious agenda, and they're going to drive it down our throats, and if you don't like it, leave the state. I mean, they have this agenda that's very divisive. So in order for us to have the kind of agenda that's going to be accepting and diverse, we need people like us in Richmond. And that's why I'm so excited to be here to support my friend Hung, and he's going to work his heart out to make sure he wins this thing. But on November 5th of this year, good news is, Hung and I will not be the only names on the ballot. We'll have our good friend Serdikov, Ralph Northam, we'll have Mark Harry leading our statewide ticket. And if you're ever trying, we're also very, very, very fortunate to have an incredible, talented candidate for sheriff, Stacey Kincaid, who will make history as the first female sheriff of the Lee County, Virginia. By having Stacey, I'm going to be holding on to her coat too, because she's going to help me win in November. And just like that, Hung's going to hold on to your coat tails, because you're going to bring out some voters that we can't reach, and vice versa. Hung's going to bring out some voters that he can't reach. And so this campaign is all about all of us as Democrats helping each other, working together, because the kind of government you want, the kind of public policies you want, is that kind of policy that represents everyone's interests. That's why I'm so excited to be here and help support my friend Hung, and to, well, we had a couple more people before we get to Hung, so to introduce the next reasons, if that wasn't enough for you to support Hung, the next reasons why you need to support Hung is my very good friend, the town of Herndon's councilwoman, and somebody who's made history herself as our first Asian American woman in Herndon, Grace